Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be a review on the Star Wars Ahsoka series Retro Collection Morgan Elsbeth figure. I do have this figure. I got another one to open and review. Morgan was my favorite Ahsoka character, so I've been getting two of every figure of her so far. And because I just really enjoyed and loved her character, so this is probably the last figure review I'll do of her until they make another one, which I hope they do make another one with the Sword of Talzin and in her Night Sister makeup, because that would be really cool. But until then, we have this one. I did review the Black Series one and the Vintage Collection one, and until we get another one, we're just going to take a look at this one. The packaging is the same as if I bring in the Vintage Collection one. This is my open one. As you can see, the pictures are the same. The font is the same. And the only difference is there's the retro sticker on the retro one to tell you that it is the Retro Collection one. So that's the only one. I would have liked to see a different picture of her maybe on the packaging, but it's not a big deal. There's the figure, the Retro Collection sticker, Kenner logo. It says Morgan Elsbeth on the top there, Star Wars Ahsoka, ages 4+. On the back, there is a standard read up on the Retro Collection. And then the other figures in the wave are these characters right here. The only other one I would get is probably Hera, because she was my other favorite character. And I got this at GameStop for $11.99. I also got the Vintage Collection Harrison Dula, but she's hanging on the wall, so. And then we have the Hasbro and Disney logo right there. So, I have my knife, and I'm going to be very careful because I do keep the packaging, opening this. This is my first Retro Collection figure I'm opening. I do have other ones, but I usually leave them in the packaging because they're more meant for the packaging. Let me see if I can... So she's out of the box, and I'm gonna bring the Vintage Collection one in just a second, but I'm gonna zoom in. I do have the Grogu or the Child and Hoth Leia Retro Collection figures, but they're still in the packaging, and I'm not gonna open them unless I get other ones, second ones. So here's Morgan. Her articulation is, things are funny, I am on a bed, so. Her articulation is a swivel in the head, swivel in the shoulders, and swivel in the hips. So, very standard articulation. She's supposed to be mimicking a Vintage Kenner figure, so she doesn't have the fancy articulation like, let's say, Vintage Collection does. Her face obviously doesn't look like Diana Lee and Jacinto, who plays her, because the old Kenner figures didn't really look like the actors, or actresses. The detail on her hair is nice. It's just all one color, unlike the Vintage Collection one, where it's a different shade. You have, nice, her arm wrappings are nicely done. Unfortunately, you can't do anything. You can't put her hands behind her back. So she's just going to be standing there. Then her dress or her skirt is nicely sculpted as well. And obviously back in the day, they look like pants, like on the Princess Leia figure and the Emperor Palpatine figure. If you moved it, it looked like pants. And she does have peg holes at the bottom of her feet. I hope she fits on a base. And there's the back of her. So there is Morgan. here's the Vintage Collection one. And they're about the same size or length. They're about the same size. And you can just see the differences there. Obviously, I prefer the Vintage Collection one. Just because she has more articulation. And she has more detail. And looks more like Diana, who played her. But I had to get the Retro Collection one. And she has a soft goods dress. Or skirt. Or whatever you want to call it. Just the Vintage Collection one is... And she is also missing her tattoo on her forehead that she has in the show on the Retro Collection one. I also have the Black Series one, but that's kind of a figure it's in it of its own arena. I didn't get down to compare. So I'm just comparing the Vintage Collection one to the Retro Collection one. So let me know which one is your favorite between the two, the Retro Collection one or the Vintage Collection one. I'm obviously going with the Vintage Collection one because just more detail. And yeah, but I do have another one carded. So I did get another one to leave on the card. But I'm glad to have both, obviously. She was a great character and villain, in my opinion. She's my favorite Star Wars female villain after Emperor Palpatine. Who is the best Star Wars villain, in my opinion. But Morgan was a great character, and unfortunately, spoiler alert, she was killed off in the show, and I hope there's some way they can bring her back in future Star Wars projects, because she was a great character, in my opinion. So, I'm just gonna move. Let's first see if she'll fit on this base, and I hope she does. Okay, she does not, because her peg holes are too big. Nope, she does not. But the Vintage Collection one, so she'll just have to stand on my shelf. The Vintage Collection one here does fit on the base. Because I recently put most of my Star Wars figures on stands, so they help don't fall over. But hey, if they don't stand up, they don't stand up, so... She stays on a base. But overall, a simple figure. She doesn't come with any accessories or anything. Like I said, I would love to see them come out with another one with her Night Sister makeup and her Sword of Talzin. And I forgot to show you the wrappings around her hands too. And her belt. It's a pretty cool figure for what it is. Unfortunately, at my Walmart, there are two Morgan figures from the Black Series and Vintage Collection peg-warming right now. I know, and then at my GameStop, she was peg-warming too until I bought her. And I know she doesn't come with any accessories, so that's like a turn-off for a lot of people. So the people who want Morgan figures are going to get them, and other people who don't want them are probably going to pass on them. Overall, I want to get them all. I just need the Funko Pops and the Lego, then I'll have all the Morgan figures so far, because since she was my favorite character, I do want them all. She was a great character to me. So that's going to do it for this review. Let me know if you picked her up. Let me know if you picked up the Vintage Collection one. Overall, let me know your thoughts on the figure down below. Thanks for watching. Please check out my Instagram page where I do daily posting at the 101 Jenko. And until the next time, until the next video, I will see you guys later. Bye.